Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. A warm welcome to all of you from wherever you are joining us. We are coming to you live from St. Peter's Square on this, the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. And of course, it is the 1st of September, and the Church celebrates the World Day of Prayer for the Care of Creation. And here we are, joining this enthusiastic crowd at St. Peter's. We gather for our weekly appointment with the Holy Father, Pope Francis. He will be joining us shortly, and together we will, with him, we will pray the Angelus prayer at noon. On behalf of Vatican Media, I welcome all of you who are joining us today for this live broadcast. Some of you are joining us through various Vatican news channels, maybe the Vatican News Live Events app, the Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News English web portal, YouTube channel, or Facebook live feed. Welcome to all of you joining us through Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television, EWTN TV, Salt and Light Television, Shalom World TV India, at Madarshan TV India, and all of you joining us through radio stations, especially those joining us through Radio Maria, Papua New Guinea, Luminous Radio in India, and Radio Maria in England. And all of you tuning in through other local diocesan radio broadcasts, or those of you picking up the shortwave transmission. I extend a warm welcome as well to those of you joining us through our American Sign Language broadcast. And to all of you joining us through other internet sites and digital platforms throughout the world, welcome to you all. It is good to have you with us as we gather for a moment of prayer with our Holy Father, Pope Francis. And of course, my name is Bonga Majola, and I am glad to be able to provide with you the English translation today. As he usually does, before leading the recitation of the Angelus prayer, Pope Francis will offer a reflection, and normally based on today's Gospel, a reading taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 7. And after that catechesis, the Holy Father will share with us his concerns and whatever is in his mind these days, and then he will greet some of specific groups, especially those that have gathered here at St. Peter's Square. It's a beautiful day, beautiful Sunday here in Rome today. Those of you following us on the screens, on TV, you can see the window is where the Holy Father will be appearing. He's already prepared. And in a few minutes, in a few seconds, the Holy Father will appear and we will welcome him. And of course, September 1st, a celebration of God's decision to create. We're celebrating creation. We're celebrating the World Day of Prayer for Care of Creation on this day. And here is the Holy Father. He's ready. We join the crowd and we upload and we welcome the Holy Father.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buona domenica.
Dear brothers and sisters, happy Sunday.
Oggi nel Vangelo della liturgia Gesù parla del puro e dell'impuro.
Today in the Gospel of the liturgy, Jesus speaks about the pure and the impure. A matter very dear to his contemporaries, which was linked principally to the observances of rites and rules of behavior, to avoid any contact with things or persons considered unclean. And if this happened, to erase the stain. It was some kind of an obsession that some of the religious of those times, the purity and impurity was so important for them. Some scribes and Pharisees, strict observers of such norms, They accuse Jesus of allowing his disciples to eat with hands defiled, hands that are unwashed. And Jesus seizes the opportunity to invite them to reflect on the meaning of purity. Purity, says Jesus, is not linked to external rites, but first and foremost to inner dispositions. To be pure, therefore, it is no use washing one's hands several times. If one then harbors evil feelings, such as greed, envy, and pride, or evil intentions such as deceit, theft, betrayal, and slander, Jesus calls the intention to what we call ritualism, which does not make one grow in goodness. On the contrary, it can sometimes lead one to neglect or even justify in oneself and in others choices and attitudes contrary to charity, which wound the soul and seal the heart. And this, my brothers and sisters, we carry it as well ourselves. And this is important for us. One cannot, for an example, leave Holy Mass and still in front of the church stop and gossip wickedly and mercilessly about everything and everyone. That gossiping which destroys the heart. It's impossible that you go to Mass and then you continue doing these things. It's an ugly thing. Or show oneself to be pious in prayer and then treat one's own relatives at home with coldness and detachment, or neglect their elderly parents who are in need of help and company. This is double life, and we cannot live like this. And this is what the Pharisees did. Purity, exterior purity without interior good attitudes, merciful attitudes with others. Or even being apparently very decent to everyone, perhaps even doing a bit of voluntary work, and some inside cultivating hatred towards others, despising the poor and the least, or behaving dishonestly in one's work. In acting this way, the relationship with God is reduced to external gestures, and within one remains impervious to the purifying action of His grace, indulging in thoughts, messages, and behavior without love. No, we are not made for this, but for true purity, tenderness, love. Let us ask ourselves then, do I live my faith in a consistent manner, in a coherent way, that what I do in the church, and I'm able to do it with the same spirit outside with others, with sentiments, words, and deeds? Do I make what I say in prayer tangible, in closeness and respect for my brothers and sisters? Let us think of these. May Mary, Mother most pure, help us to make our life in heartfelt and practiced love, worship pleasing to God.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, e benedicto frutto venti tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, e benedicto frutto venti tui, Jesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
E verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Gentis.
Ut in ineficiam promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo annunciante, Christi Fili tu, incarnatione cognovium, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucet Deis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Et hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Adiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, yesterday in Šanstín, in Slovakia, Jan Havlik was beatified. He was a seminarist of the Congregation of the Missions, founded by Saint Vincenzo of Saint Vincent Paulino. He was killed in 1975 during the persecution and the regime against the Church in the then Czechoslovakia. His perseverance and his witness and to bear witness to Christ, may it be an encouragement to those that continue today to go through similar challenges. With pain, I have learned that on Saturday, on the 24th of August in Burkina Faso, hundreds of people, women and children, were killed and others were wounded in a terrorist attack. In condemning these grave actions against human life, I bring my closeness to the whole nation, and I'm close to the families of the victims. May the Virgin Mary help the people of Burkina Faso to refind peace and security. I also pray for the victims of the incident which happened in the sanctuary of our Nostra Senhora Constanção in Recife in Brazil. May the risen Lord comfort all those who were wounded and the families and their families. I am always very close to the people of Ukraine who continue to be attacked against attacks against infrastructure in that country and wounding and killing many people. And this has left a lot of people without electricity and water. Let us once again remind ourselves that the voice of the innocent may always be listened to, and God listens to the voice of the innocent, and He doesn't remain indifferent to their suffering. Once again, I turn with my thoughts with preoccupation to the conflict in Palestine and Israel that continue to risk to continue to other Palestinian cities. I once again make an appeal that negotiations must not stop, that there must be ceasefire immediately, and that we must release the hostages. And we can see that there's also a lot of diseases that are currently spreading in this part of the world. Let be peace in Holy Land. Let there be peace in Jerusalem. The holy city must be a place of encounter where Christians and Jews and Islam will all feel respected and welcomed. And no one must put into discussion the status quo in all the respective holy places. Today we celebrate the day for prayer for the care of creation. I wish everyone, institutions, associations and families, and each and every person who has taken a concrete commitment for our common home, the cry of the earth that is wounded is becoming more and more alarming and asking for a decisive decision. Tomorrow I will begin a trip, apostolic trip, in some of the countries of Asia. Please, I invite you to pray for me and to pray for the fruitfulness of this trip, the success of this trip. I greet all of you pilgrims from Rome in a special way. I greet the young people from Lucca who are accompanied by their Archbishop, Monsignor Paolo Giulietti, who is here, and some priests. I greet the young people of the Immaculata. Ragazzi di Campo Croce in Milano. And to all of you,
buona domenica. Per favore, non dimenticatevi di pregare per me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
And I wish you then, all of you, a happy Sunday, and please don't forget to pray for me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci. And that's how then the Holy Father concludes this prayer of the Angelus on this Sunday at noon. Started with his reflection on impurity and purity based on the Gospel of Mark chapter 7 that was proclaimed during Mass on this, the 22nd Sunday. And the Holy Father reminded us as well of the day of prayer for the care of creation and the cry of the Mother Earth. And he informed us as well about his apostolic trip, which will be taking from tomorrow in the countries of Asia, Indonesia, Papua New Guinea, Singapore, and Timor-Leste. And the Holy Father has asked us to accompany him with our prayers. And then, of course, he continued to pray as well for peace in all the countries where there is war, especially for those where there has been terrorist attacks as well in Burkina Faso, and he also prayed about the incident that took place in Brazil, and he asked us to pray for all these victims, and he assured them of his closeness and his prayers. And then with the people of Slovakia, with the new blessed who was beatified a few days ago. And then this ends the live broadcast of the recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis here at St. Peter's Square on this, the 22nd day in ordinary time, the 22nd Sunday in ordinary time. Please visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube account for coverage of today's liturgy. Thank you once again for joining us. My name is Bonga Majola. Blessed Sunday to you all. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.